I was wrong, and I'm sorry. Remember when I dropped that bombshell video about full range of motion being dead? Well, science has thrown a curveball, and it's time to address the elephant in the gym. Is full range of motion back? What's up? I'm Lockie, your resident sports science enthusiast, here to break down complex research into actionable training strategies. As a final year sport and exercise science student at Oxford Brookes University, I'm passionate about separating facts from bro science. Today we're tackling the great range of motion debate, armed with fresh research, including a new preprint groundbreaking study on partial versus full range of motion exercises. So in today's video, you're going to learn the science behind why focusing on the stretch position, whether you do full or partial range of motion, is a non-negotiable for growth. The surprising findings of a brand new study conducted by Wolf and colleagues who challenged the status quo of full range of motion versus length and partials, and my updated training recommendations to help you maximize your sweet, sweet gains. So muscle growth or hypertrophy boils down to two key players, active tension and passive tension. Active tension is a muscle flexing its might, contracting to move the weight. Think bicep curl, bench press, and all that good stuff. Passive tension, on the other hand, is where the magic happens at longer muscle lengths. Imagine stretching a rubber band. The more you pull, the more tension you create. Now, studies show when you train at longer muscle lengths, like the bottom of a Romanian deadlift or the peak stretch of an incline dumbbell curl, this is where more passive tension becomes present. And this mechanical overload signals your muscles to grow bigger and stronger. For years, the fitness community, including myself, championed length and partials as the ultimate key to maximizing passive tension and unlocking more hypertrophy. And many people deemed full range of motion as practically irrelevant for gains. Or you should hold on to your dumbbells, because things just got interesting. Recent research shows that full range of motion training, when executed with an emphasis on the stretch position, can be just as effective as length and partials for muscle growth. Now, like most, this revelation hit me hard, especially after making a full video saying that full range of motion is dead and that length and partials are the key. Although I did state that you shouldn't completely neglect full range of motion, you should just include partial or length and partials within your exercises. And thankfully, researchers like Wolf and colleagues have spent so much effort investigating this very topic. They conducted a study with a group of highly trained individuals, with each participant boasting at least 6 months of dedicated lifting experience. This is to make sure that adaptations that occur during your first 6 months of training do not become a factor, therefore it's one less thing to worry about during the study. And this is obviously huge because most of the research done on this topic has been with untrained individuals. And to make this even more applicable to your training, Wolf and colleagues use a variety of upper body exercises in the study. So this means we're dealing with some seriously applicable science here. The results? Muscle thickness measurements revealed similar growth in both the elbow flexors and extensors between both groups. Full range of motion, with that intentional lengthened emphasis, went toe-to-toe with lengthened partials and came out victorious. Well, kind of victorious, like they drew, but you know what I mean. Why don't you thinking, well, lengthened partials are dead then, aren't they? And they are absolutely not. So before you ditch your lengthened partials or your stretch-mediated hypertrophy ideas altogether, let's pump the brakes and cover a few things. Exactly like what's happened in this situation, science is always evolving. We need more studies using resistance-trained individuals to solidify these findings. And it's not to say these findings are wrong, but you cannot just take one meta-analysis and completely change the way you train. I mean, I'm sure you can, but it's not recommended, I would say. So science is about constant exploration, and I'm excited to see what science uncovers next. And it's extremely important to note that during this study, the people that were using full range of motion used an emphasis on the stretched portion. And if you are not training like that, you will not see the benefits of it. So just to quickly explain that, if you're doing an incline dumbbell curl and you do not leave a stretch at the bottom of the movement, you are missing out the gains that this study is referring to. Because I guarantee if they compared three groups, one where it's full range of motion without an emphasized stretch, one where it's full range of motion with an emphasized stretch and just length and partials, these two would get the same amount of hypertrophy, this one would get less. So the only way these two gained the same amounts of hypertrophy is because there was an emphasis on the stretch. But I am very curious to know if this means we don't need to do the full range of motion if you're getting the same gains from length and partials as you are full range of motion with the stretched position emphasized, because that just means potentially the fully contracted position isn't providing any benefit. I'm not stating that's the truth, I'm just saying that's a potential outcome. Also, exercise selection is key because not every exercise was made to emphasize the stretch. For example, a Romanian deadlift will naturally stretch the hamstrings a lot more than an exercise like the leg curl will. So that's one very important thing to bear in mind, is that when you're picking your exercises and you want to do a range of motion where you emphasize the stretch, but it's a full range of motion, you need to be picking exercises where the muscle will become naturally stretched anyway. And I think a very obvious one that goes without saying anyway is that individualization is paramount. Because your body is unique, what might work for one person might feel awful for the next. So listen to your body, respect your limitations, and find what allows you to gain the best stretch with good form. Here's the paradigm shift. It's not a black and white battle of full range of motion versus length and partials, because the real MVP is the stretch itself. If you're interested in seeing my recent video when I talked about how full range of motion is potentially dead, click the link at the top of the screen and it'll take you straight to it. So let's recap. Training at longer muscle lengths, where passive tension reigns supreme, is a non-negotiable for muscle growth, and you should be applying this to all of your training sessions. Recent research, including the study by Wolf and colleagues, although that's not the only one, highlighted that full range of motion with an emphasized stretch elicits equal levels of hypertrophy when compared to length and partials. And it's important to experiment with different approaches. Prioritize what allows you to get a good stretch with even better form. And tailor your training to your unique goals and limitations, because they're all different for everyone. Now, I want to hear your thoughts. Drop a comment below sharing your experiences with full range of motion, length and partials, or your own hybrid approach. Have you experienced different levels of hypertrophy with different types of range of motion? Let's get the discussion pumping in the comments. Don't forget to smash the like button if this video expanded your training horizons, and subscribe for more science-based fitness wisdom. That's all from me on this one, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.